It is with great pleasure that we introduce today's host of the Roswell Interview, Insights into Humanity's Cosmic History, Part 3 of 3, Dr. Zhou Qingrong. With a PhD in Electrical Engineering and Computer Science, Dr. Zhou has been involved in telecommunications for 29 years. He has supported the evolution of wireless network technologies from 1G through 4G, with 5G now just around the corner. As a distinguished member of technical staff at Nokia Corporation, his primary focus is perfecting mobile network performance for a bright future of enhanced communication.
欢迎亲切的观众收看罗斯威尔事件访谈，洞悉人类的宇宙历史节目的最后一集。我是周庆荣，来自有福气的台湾，台湾又称为福尔摩沙。台湾人民由衷祝福您蒙受天堂恩泽，生活喜乐平静，充满爱心。我们在之前的节目中知道，在1947年有一架幽浮坠毁，他们在坠毁现场找到一位外星人，后来更有美国空军护士马克埃罗伊女士对这位外星人进行访谈。这位外星人名叫埃罗，是那架幽浮的驾驶。他告诉马克埃罗伊女士，地球其实是一座星际监狱，用来监禁从其他星球送过来的众生。外星人访谈这本书记载了埃罗的谈话内容，编辑并出版这本书的是劳伦斯·斯宾塞。我们请教他，埃罗这位驾驶对囚禁我们的这套先进科技系统究竟知道多少？
Well, as I recall, the pilot says that they haven't been able to discover exactly the exact nature of the prison system, which is fairly complicated, the nature of it is vast and multifaceted. It's not just like building a wall. It's a very specific combination of lots and lots of different elements, amnesia, isolation,not just the memory erasure, but the replacement of actual memory with false memories.
如果地球上所有众生真的都是囚犯，我们有办法脱逃吗？有没有人逃狱成功呢？我们该怎么做才能脱逃？斯宾塞先生接着告诉我们，这位外星驾驶的说明。
Pilot said something about Buddha may have been one person who was able to transcend that, the prison planet situation, or Lao Tzu. The pilot refers to Lao Tzu in the context of the history of Earth as a kind of example of a philosopher or a being who may, by their personal mental or spiritual discipline, may have been able to raise themselves above the level of being trapped by a physical universe or biological body.
So studying with the saintly being could be one of the ways that we could potentially free ourselves.
Possibly.
Possibly. I mean, but they also,
who knows?
In that regard.
Well, the nurse says, makes a comment in the last letter that's included in the book, is that we're going to have to pull ourselves up by our bootstraps and rise above being human and change our understanding and perception of who we really are as immortal spiritual beings, and really just stop buying the lie that you're a biological body, that you're mortal, that you have limitations that you're in some artificially created time stream or something. She does say very specifically that what we consider to be science on this planet is not an answer to anything. It's not an answer to any problem. For one, science in the context of Western civilization worships the physical universe, so to speak. It's all about the physical universe, and there is no spiritual being, there is no individual immortality in the context of Western science. It's all materialism. It's all atoms and molecules and bombs and bacteria, and it's all a physical phenomena which somehow miraculously appeared all by itself from nothing. We have to remember that everyone on this planet, including the scientists and the priests and the so-called leaders and the peasants and whom, whatever the population is on this planet, we all share the common reality that we're imprisoned in biological bodies and we all have amnesia.
外星人埃罗揭露的讯息真是令人惊讶。我们先出去一会儿，感谢出现在天空中的繁星，马上回来。欢迎继续收看我们独家专访劳伦斯·斯宾塞先生，进一步了解《外星人访谈》这本书揭露的讯息。斯宾塞先生这本书曾引起高度争议，我们请教斯宾塞先生，他当初收到马克·埃罗伊女士寄来这些与外星人访谈的机密文件，是否曾担心过自己的安危？
But when I received it, I was very skeptical, and because they were represented to me as being essentially stolen, top-secret government documents, I thought, wow, this is not good. I have a family. So the last thing I want, and she warns me in the letter that she wrote, you know, don't endanger yourself by publishing the material. So I consider that to be a genuine threat or concern, so I didn't tell anybody about any of the material, not even my wife, who to this day, I mean, she never saw any of this stuff. I never showed it to anybody for that reason, because of the nurse's warning. So I kept it all to myself, and I studied it very carefully, and I spent a lot of time researching, which became what the footnotes are in the book. It was my attempt to verify to the best of my ability that there was some degree of authenticity, of factuality. So after many months of doing that, I satisfied myself that, well, it's worth publishing because the information is very revealing and dramatic in the context of Earth. Whether it's true or not, it's very thought-provoking information, to say the least. So I destroyed all the original documents so that I couldn't be attacked subsequently, as she suggests. She said, well, why don't you take all this and write it as part of a science fiction book, so if anybody asks you, you can say, oh, I just made the whole thing up. So I've always represented this book, as I wrote in the disclaimer at the beginning of the book, that this is what it is. I'm just putting it out there as exactly as I received it without any alteration. I just typed it mechanically, letter for letter. And there it is. Make up your mind.
What is your personal wish for humankind?
Well, obviously, like everyone else, I don't want to remain enslaved in a biological body, going through the cycle of death, life, rebirth, pain, agony, suffering, deprivation, blindness. I mean, a biological body is essentially guarantees that your perception of the physical universe is limited to about 1% of the whole electromagnetic spectrum, which is almost nothing. Both hearing, sight, any other perception that you have of the physical universe through a biological body virtually disables you completely. There are so many, many more life forms on this body that have a vast ability to perceive things in the physical universe than human biological bodies do. Generally, our inability to perceive and communicate directly as spiritual beings, the way the domain does, apparently, according to the pilot, really puts us in a bad spot for the rest of eternity if we don't figure out some way to transcend this, or if the domain or somebody from the outside who has some sort of benevolent attention comes back and rescues us, so to speak, or dismantles this mechanism by whatever means.
2017年 7月 23日, 青海无上师在福尔摩沙西湖, 福尔摩沙又称为台湾, 一场开示中, 提到许多论点, 内容与外星人揭露的讯息, 不谋而合.
Originally, all of you, any of you, all came from very high level of existence. Some of you have had some, other bodies, physical bodies. Some of you don't. It depends on which planet you come from. The proof that you came from a more highly sophisticated planet and a better quality of life is that you are here. Understand? Because if it's not for that, you will never be able to come here. You are sent here, you're exiled here by high technology and by some soup that you drink before you came. They force you to do it. Long time ago, yeah. Maybe 1,000 years ago, they put up this kind of, I'll just say radar system, okay? Because I don't know how to explain this. Some kind of borders, yeah? All around the planet. And only the people they want to be here can be here, yeah? Even the one, the agents who work for them and all that. Otherwise, no one can come and go. Therefore, we are in prison here, huh? Me, you, okay? Except we can go in and out sometime in our soul, and that is important. It's a horrible system. I hate this. I don't like that. And then they make human crazy out of frustration, because the humans, this race of human, they came from a higher society, They were free thinker people. There are some high-tech inventors, scientists, healers, engineers in their homeland. And then because they make some mistakes, they've been exiled here. And forget everything, forget all the talents they have, forget all the freedom they have, and forget what glory their being was before they came down here. But somehow, in some little remote corner of their mind, they feel something is not right about themselves in this environment, in their own situation. So they feel very frustrated. And that's why nobody is happy on this planet.
地球是一座星际监狱, 几乎不可能逃脱。 这则来自青海无上师的消息, 令人感到沮丧。 然而, 2017年 10月 1日, 青海无上师在福尔摩沙西湖, 福尔摩沙又称为台湾, 另一场开示中, 却发布了一项重大讯息。
我告诉你们一个好消息, 本来我第一次下来就很累, 不过很激动, 告诉你们了, 那一个哈, 我们那些那个天上的那个强壮的那些神哈, 那些小上帝了啊，那些从 EOS 上面啊，额外一点了，他们就把那个世界的所有的那个控制的器官全部 smashed. That's what they are. 全部，因为我累了，我不想在那边忍住了。我说好了，不管怎么样，业障就业障，我是，福报就福报，我管了，把全部破掉。还有总今天什么人不好的话，送到别的地方去，送回家。嗯。送回自己那个地方呢，我重复那个英文的那个消息 ，OK？ 因为我就事实上是昨天晚上了 啊，我问他们，我交代事情有没有弄了，他就说有弄，这样英文就一句而已 ，did， 意思说处理好了，中文就讲那么多话的。我就问 ，Did you do what I ask? Did， 这样子。然后我问，因为我怕我不懂，或是他们不懂，我说我问什么东西啊？我就问，那 What did you do？ 你说处理好了，你怎么处理？你们怎么处理？他就说 ，smashed。All the machines, yeah. 还有，take care of all the bad. yeah, something like that. 这样的 ，OK， 意思说他把全部那些机器啊，你们看不到的，我们看不到，全部 smashed， 表示说 smashed， 表示说全部弄打碎就对了，了解吗？打碎了啊，只有他们能够啊。连那个阿修罗神通那些三界以内五界以下五界以上没办法，所以啊，我觉得很重要，就是你们不是拍手而已，帮我谢谢那些从 EOS 过去的那些神 ，OK 哈，每天以前啊，要谢谢最高的上帝允许，还有谢谢他们帮我助手。我每天谢谢他们了，不过小事情，今天真的大事情要谢谢，要请大家帮忙我一起谢谢的 ，OK？ 为这个很大了，就很大，当然不会有马上影响了，啊，不会，最少就是两个月以后了，才觉得那种影响 ，OK？ 那你们打坐会更轻松 ，OK？
开悟的人的话，又会更开悟，更了解，更明确，明确东西。不开悟的人，就会慢慢醒过来，就会明白，会更有道德。有一些，当然很快就明白了，有一些就比较慢一点。感谢高度进化的观众，今天收看罗斯威尔事件访谈。洞悉人类的宇宙历史节目的最后一集，
无上师电视台接下来播出师徒之间认识自己的伟大
两集节目的第一集，祝福大家都享有自由尊严的生活，彼此互相尊重，也祝福大家爱心天天增长。 Thank you highly evolved viewers for watching today's final episode of the Roswell Interview, Insights into Humanity's Cosmic History. Coming up next is Recognizing Your Greatness,
Part 2 of 2,
Between Master and Disciples, here on Supreme Master Television. May you all enjoy lives of freedom, dignity, and mutual respect.And may your compassion grow with each passing day. For more details, please visit suprememastertv.com/ss.